Hello from Quarantine Finland.
Terve! So now we have been in a self-quarantine or a self-isolation for 2 weeks. We came back from our trip to Canary Islands 2 weeks ago on the day when World Health Organization announced pandemic. After that, Finland took measures and asked everybody who came back from recent travels to go for a self-quarantine or self-isolation for 2 weeks. So that's what we've been up to.
I've been still going to work because I don't work so closely to other people, and also that my new employer allowed it, that if I show no symptoms, I can come to work, and everything's been fine.
Yeah, we came back with no symptoms whatsoever and have been no symptoms for 2 weeks. And now Sebastian is back to daycare, which he's really, really happy. I mean, we had a good time with him at home as well. If you want to see how our days went by, check our link in our latest video down below. But in generally, like, I think he missed having other children around. He's really enjoying the company.
Every time we were passing by this playground, and there are other kids playing because people are home, so they go to playground, and like, I want to go there.
Yeah, he wanted like kids so badly, but we've been usually just going to play with him in the forest because I still was kind of trying to avoid going to any other people nearby if we have something, just in case that it doesn't go anywhere. But 2 weeks was up, we're all feeling great and trying to get back to our life as much as we can. So I'm starting a new job and I'm planning to go to the office for a couple of days to get all the instructions and tasks and then take the work home so I can also just work from home and be as isolated as possible. Basically, we are not going to the crowded playgrounds ever. We don't go basically anywhere. We're just going home and he goes to work. And I think the most public place we ever go is the grocery shop.
Yeah, I try to go as little as possible, but every now and then if we forget something, I need to go. But in general, the shops are more empty, even in the rush hours after work. Like,
yeah, it looks
compared
peaceful.
To usual. Yeah. Especially the bigger shops where there is a lot of space, like, it sometimes looks really empty.
I actually didn't notice any more panic.
No.
Like, I didn't see any more this toilet paper craziness or anything.
No, last weekend already there was toilet paper on the shelf.
So you see, things are stabilizing. People are coming down a bit.
But the latest measures that Finland has taken to fight the coronavirus back is that yesterday at midnight, Uusimaa, which is the capital region, was closed down. And it's in isolation now, so you cannot go anywhere unless you have a very, very good reason. The capital region is now in isolation. And also, it's not a law passed yet, but the government is asking that the restaurants close, except with the exception of takeaway food. And many of the restaurants, especially the lunch places like around my work, like, they closed down this week. So you cannot go eat out anymore anywhere. You have to always have food with you.
Yes.
Or then if you have places where you can take away food.
Or order it online.
Yeah, of course.
We are not so much on the streets to see the general mood, but for us it seems very calm. Like, people are following the orders and trying to keep distances. I go for 1 hour walk in a forest every day, and even there people always give me space. Like, everybody is very, you know, nice to give about a couple of meters space between each other. We step out of the path and we give each other space to turn around. Like people are just trying to act like in the best way possible.
Yes.
Yeah, and I don't see any more panic personally. Like, the last place which panicked me was the shop. It was two weeks ago. But I think
that's
now
when
this
it all started. Like, then people were like
overreacting a bit.
Yeah,
but now I don't see this anymore.
Mm.
And I was actually thinking about like a psychological effect of this experience. I think this is very interesting experience. Of course, like, that's not a fun to have a coronavirus. It's not fun to stay home, locked in a locked home, especially if you have little kids. but this is a very interesting time because, you know, like you, especially if you're outgoing person, if you're not very introverted, we don't always face ourselves, you know. Like, you know why meditation is so hard? Because you have to be there in peace and quiet with yourself and just hear all those thoughts. And like, kind of, we always numb ourselves with the things. Like, we watch TV, like some TV shows. We meet friends. We go for a drink. You know, we keep ourselves busy so we don't have to be with ourselves, you know, because that's really hard to face yourself, which is kind of hilarious, but that's what we usually do as people. That's why they always say that meditation is so hard and it also so like beneficial for you. But it is a state of crisis, kind of, and I think of crisis also like of like a bad storm at the sea. Like, if you're in a boat, you have, like, two choices. You're either, like, gonna completely collapse under the sea and get panicked and, like, make it destroy you. Or you can, like, come out of the sea all, like, fresh and washed and, like, a brand new person. So, like, this is interesting time for, like, a self-growth or, like, self-exploration or acceptance of yourself. Or even, like, I don't know, like, healing relationships in your family. Like being with each other, listening to it, because you don't actually have any other choice. You are stuck with each other at home. Like, you can either like really push them away or you can like let them in and accept them and like be with them. This is, I was joking to Petri the other day, is like probably when the quarantine is over, there's going to be a baby boom by the Christmas next year, you know, because there is not many other things to do at home, you know. And then there was interesting statistics from China that after now their lockdown is almost over, that there is increased rate of divorces, which also makes me think that maybe like if you're stuck with each other and you're not dealing maybe with the issues which have already been brewing, kind of, and you're forced to coexist and you don't have any breather because there are no other like distractions. You cannot go away and not deal with your partner and just forget about the fight and like move on and go to work and go out with your friends. Like, you are just there stuck with each other and like you have to deal with all the issues. So as with the storm, I think it either can like bring you really really close together, like you will go deep in your relationship and like accept each other and, you know, like try to discuss and apologize for all the things that have happened, or you can like escalate it. Like, this is very interesting. I think like after this whole thing is over, there will be lots of articles from psychologists like talking about, like, because it's a grand experiment on the whole world, when the whole world goes to lockdown. It's not that just our family goes through that. It's not that just Finland goes through this experience. It's every country has some sort of lockdown already. And I think it can do us good if we take an opportunity and think positive about it and try to make changes maybe we always wanted to make. I just wanted to kind of raise this idea and make it linger a bit and know what you think about this kind of like a crisis storm situation. Like, what do you think is going to happen in like psychologically speaking,
after it's over,
because you kind of locked down and you're cooking in your own bubble for a while because you don't have much more distraction except maybe like watching Netflix and stuff like that. But like, you're all together all the time. This is such a rare experience and it is on this kind of grand scale of the whole world. Like, I think it can do really great for many people, especially if they have an attitude. So guys, let us know how your self-isolation or lockdown is going on. How is your psychological state? Have you noticed any positive changes? Have you tried to do something positive for you and your family? Have you tried to kind of benefit from this isolation? Or is this just been really hard on you? Like, I think it also can be both. It can be hard on you and it can benefit you in some way. But I'm just curious, how is it going for you? And what do you think, what is going to happen when this whole lockdown worldwide is going to end? Like, what kind of changes is going to bring? Thank you so much for watching.
See you next time.
Please like and subscribe. Bye.
Bye.